Thank you very much for your money. Keep your money dropping in the book.
By May, the strike was not confined to the coal fields. The rattle of the miners' bucket became a familiar sound in Britain's towns as the miners took to the streets to raise funds for their hard-up families back home. In Birmingham, even the Sikhs came on side.
The Sikh people, believing hard-working people. And those people who work hard for their life and they love to help them.
We had to go upstairs and to eat food with the community. They were coming along with these big urns of, well, Indian, whatever it was.
We asked them, have you ever tasted Indian food before? And they said, yes, we've been to some Indian restaurant, but it wasn't that this hot.
Well, they fed us. And then we were wondering why they were coming around with a bucket of water and a ladle. We soon found out.
It was a laugh that when they say, oh, more water, please, more water, please.
So they had these white sheets in the room, on the floor. Well, we had to take our shoes off, didn't we? Well, after the day's picket in, you know, your feet are a bit sweaty, like.
They smell sometimes and they joke to be there. They say, take them off and leave them outside.
Well, we couldn't do nothing about it, I mean, because all the boys are looking, and look at these footprints. And of course, we'd have a hanky tied on your head and all. Oh. So we got on the right one. So I got the utmost admiration for Sikhs. Oh, aye.